two window washing companies are represented in this table below. Clean Fast, that's $15 plus $2 per window, and See Out is $5 plus $3 per window. So number one says, which expressions show the cost for each company, where X is the number of windows? They defined our variables for us. That's the X. So since X is the number of windows, this will be 15 and then plus $2 per window, per in this case, meaning multiply. So we'll multiply two times the number of windows, X. So it'll be 2X. And then for C out, that'll be $5 plus $3 per window. The X being the number of windows, that'll be 3X. And if you notice right here, that's going to be B, because 15 plus 2X for the Clean Fast is right here. And then 5 plus 3X for the C out. Both expressions are going to be brought down for number two. And it says, for how many windows do the two companies charge the same amount? Solve the equation below to find out. So even if they didn't give us this equation, we know that for us to see how many windows that would be for them to have the same amount, we would just set those two expressions equal to each other. They've done that for us, which was nice. And we can go ahead, notice the 15 plus 2x is here, 5 plus 3x is here. That's going to be the Clean Fast on this side and the C out on this side. And so let's go ahead and solve. It's good to pick a side for variables and constants. I'm going to go ahead and choose the variables to be on this side, the constants or numbers on that side. And then I will subtract my 2x from both sides to move my variables to the right. So 2x plus a negative 2x cancels to 0. 0 plus 15 is 15, equals 5 plus 3x minus 2x is 1x, or just x. Then I will subtract 5 from both sides, and that will give us x equal to 10. Well, what does that mean to us? That means that there were 10 windows. At 10 windows, these two companies will have the same cost. We could plug that in to find out how much that cost would be. That would be 2 times 10, which is 20, plus 15, which is 35. Same for the C out. 3 times 10 is going to be 30, plus 5 will be 35. And so $35 is where they would be at the 10 windows, but that wasn't the question. They only needed to know the number of windows. Let's move on to number 3. Number 3 says, solve the inequality, negative 5x greater than negative 25. Hopefully there are some alarms going on in your head when you see that negative 5 next to x. Because if you remember from before, we've stated that if you multiply or divide both sides of the equation by a negative, then that inequality sign does need to flip. And that's going to be the case right here, because we need to divide both sides by negative 5. And negative 5 divided by negative 5 gives us a positive 1. 1 times x will give us an x. But we do need to flip that inequality, since we divided by negative. That's going to point to the x, and negative divided by negative with triangle man here. Negative divided by negative is going to be a positive, and 25 divided by 5 is 5. Therefore, x is less than 5 is my answer, and that's going to be C. All right, number four, we've got some bigger numbers now, still an inequality, but we do need to solve. And let's pick a side. It's going to be a good idea to move my variables over to the left side this time, because I have a negative 1000x. If I move it over here, it turns positive. Make sure as we do this that we stack our like terms. This is an x term. We need to stack that right underneath the other x so that it will be easier to add straight down. Let's cancel the negative 1000x plus 1000x goes to 0. 0 plus 4000, 45,000 will be 45,000. We bring down the inequality sign. 600 plus 1000 is going to be 1600x. We'll simply bring down the plus and the 32,000 right there. From there, we need the constants or just plain numbers to the right side. So we will subtract 32,000 on both sides. And we'll stack that underneath this 45,000 on the right side. And as we subtract those, we will get 13,000 here. And then we're going to bring down the 1,600x and the inequality sign. Do we have to flip this time for the inequality? No, we don't, because the number in front of x is positive. We are going to divide by 1,600 on both sides. And 1,600 divided by 1,600 is 1. 1 times x is just x. The inequality sign stays the same direction. And 13,000 divided by 1,600 will be 8.125. And my answer will be A. All right, moving on to number 5. Lon is selling gift baskets at a craft fair. His costs are $75 for the table and $12 per basket. He sells each basket for $20. Let B equal the number of baskets. So they just defined our variable for us, which expression represents Lon's cost. So if you remember to earn a profit, your cost must be larger than the dollars. The cost must be smaller than the dollars earned. You need to earn more than you're spending. Otherwise, you're going to have a rough time maintaining a business. So the dollars earned must be larger than the cost. The question that they're asking on number 5 is to write an expression for Lon's cost. It's going to be this left-hand side here. It did say that he was spending $12 per basket. So we'll go ahead and write down 12B. And then on top of that, there was a $75 cost for the table. So it's going to be a one-time cost of 75. So we will not multiply that by anything. We'll simply add plus 75 in the back. Then we're going to compare that. That's all they're asking for number 5. But I do want to fill this part out over here. His amount earned is $20 per basket. So over here, that will be 20 times the baskets, the number of baskets B. To answer the cost, that's going to be 12B plus 75. So my answer for number 5 is B. Then for number 6, it says, how many baskets must be sold to make a profit? Solve the inequality below to find out. And so they've given us the inequality, but I want to go ahead and talk about why, which side do I make the inequality eat? I want the amount earned, if I'm a business owner, I want the amount earned to be larger than the cost, the amount that I'm spending. So I make the mouth eat the dollars earned, in this case, 20B. Now it kind of looks backwards here on number 6, and that's okay, because the amount earned, the 20B, is getting eaten in this particular inequality as well. And then greater than the 12B plus 75, Lon's cost. Let's go ahead and solve and find out what B is and figure out how many baskets he'll need to earn a profit. We'll subtract. We'll say that this is the variables. This side will be the constants. We'll subtract 12B from both sides. And 20B minus 12B is 8B. Greater than, these 12 B's cancel out to 0. 0 plus 75 is 75. And then from there, we will divide both sides by 8. And B is going to be greater than 9.375. You might be saying to yourself, how do I sell 0.375 baskets? It's not going to work out. So instead, we're going to have to go up to that next possible basket. That's going to be 10. So we know that he will need to, it will be after 10 baskets that he will begin to earn a profit. Number 7, what is the solution to the inequality below? We're going to draw a line straight down and figure out which side. It doesn't really matter which side we choose for our variables and constants, But I'm going to go ahead and choose the left-hand side because if I move the negative 2.5, which is bigger than 1.5, if I move that over here, that's going to give me a positive number. So I'm going to go ahead and add plus 2.5x to both sides. And that's going to cancel my 2.5x's on that side. 0 plus 10 is going to be 10, bringing down the inequality sign, bring down the 6. And then negative $1.50 plus $2.50, that's only going to be $1. So I could put plus 1x, but 1 times x is simply x. So I'll just bring down the plus x. We'll subtract 6 from both sides. And that will give us an answer of x less than 6. Sorry. This was 4. This was 6. X less than 4. Because I subtracted 6 on both sides, then I would say X is less than 4. My answer is going to be D. Moving on, number 8. Carla has $90. She makes $6 per day walking a neighbor's dog for half an hour, but spends $7.50 per day on lunch and $6 per day she's earning. In how many days will Carla have less than $30? Solve the inequality below to find out. So just to walk through, she had $90. Then she's earning $96 per day. D is going to be X is going to be the number of days. And they've given us all this, which is nice. But the reason it's a plus 6x is because she's earning $6 per day. But then she's spending $7.50 per day on lunch. That's why it's a negative 7.5x or a minus 7.5x. And so this side over here is going to be the amount that's going to be her money. That's going to be Carla's money. Then we're going to compare that to 30. And notice it says that Carla's money is less than 30. And the reason why it should be less is because it says, when is it going to be below $30? So we're going to say that Carla's money is less than 30. Let's go ahead and solve. We need to combine like terms. That's CLT. Where are the like terms? I've got a 6x and a negative 7.5x. If you add those, that's $96 plus or subtracting $7.50. That's going to be negative 1.5x or negative $1.50x less than 30. From there, we're going to move the 90 to the other side. And that will give us negative $1.50x less than 30 plus the negative 90 will be a negative 60. And then from there, we'll divide both sides by negative $1.50. But again, the bells and whistles should be going off because we just divided by a negative. That means we need to flip the inequality sign. And that means that that's going to be going this direction. The inequality sign will. Negative $1.50 divided by negative $1.50 is 1. 1 times x is x. And negative divided by negative is positive from before, from Triangle Man there. And when we divide 60 by $1.50, that is 40. So what does that mean to us? That means that after 40 days, that Carla's balance, her amount of money will be less than $30. So the answer is going to be 41. Number 9, a train leaves Chicago traveling west at 60 miles per hour. An hour later at 12 noon, another train leaves Chicago and travels east at 80 miles per hour. Write and solve an equation to find when the two trains are the same distance from Chicago. So they were nice enough to give us both expressions, the 80x and the 60x plus 60, x being the number of hours, since we don't know the number of hours. And then how did they come about the 60x plus 60? Well, 60 miles per hour, but then on top of that, they've been traveling for an hour, meaning they have that 1 hour head start, and one times the 60 is 60. So the other train is going faster. They're going 80 miles per hour. So that's the 80X, but the westbound is plus 60. So they've got a head start. Let's go ahead and set this up. We're going to put an equal sign. We want to know when they will be the same. So we'll place the westbound over here, 60X plus 60. That was mentioned first in the problem. And then we're going to set that equal to the 80X and see when they are of equal distance from Chicago. Let's solve. I'm going to choose this side over here for my variables, this side over here, the left-hand side for my constants or other numbers. And so let's go ahead and subtract 60X from both sides. That will bring all of the letters to the right-hand side, those variables. 80X minus 60X is going to be 20X. This zeros out, and you add 0 plus 60, that'll give you 60 equal to 20X. Dividing both sides by 20, we get X equal to 3. So what does that mean to us? X is going to be, it's going to be 3 hours before they have the same distance. Moving on to number 10. Raul and Ruth are saving for a trip. Raul starts with $350 and saves $15 per week. Ruth starts with $200 and saves $25 per week. When will they have the same amount? So another equation. They've already given us the Raul sign because notice he started with $350 and $15 per week. So I'll go ahead and write down that Raul is represented over here. And then we know the X is going to be the number of weeks because it is $15 per week. So the number of weeks will be X. And that's why it is 15X, 15 times the number of weeks, plus the 350 that Raul already had. And then on the other side, we will represent Ruth with that side of the equation. We'll write her expression. She already has $200. So we can go ahead and write down the 200. And then on top of that, $25 per week, we could multiply the word per implying multiplication, 25 times the number of weeks X, so 25X. Let's choose sides for where we would like to place our variables. I've got a larger number over here for X, so I'm going to move my variables over here and my constants over here. I'll subtract the 15X from both sides. And that will give me a 0 over here. 15X plus negative 15X is 0, 0 plus 350 is 350 equal to the 200 comes down. 25X minus 15X will be a positive 10X. Then from there, we're going to subtract 200 from both sides. And we will get 10X. Those will zero out. 0 plus 10X is going to be 10X equal to 350 plus. Plus a negative 200 will be 150. And then we will divide both sides by 10. What does it mean to us? We're going to get X equal to 15. And that means it will take 15 weeks for both Raul and Ruth to have the same amount of money. Oh, can't see that. All right. Yes. X equals 15 weeks. Sorry about that. Number 11, solve 3 plus 3 fourths X equals 1/2 X. We have some rational numbers now, some fractions involved. And so let's go ahead and move all of our variables to this side and our constants to that side. And I'll get rid of the 3 fourths X on this side by subtracting 3 fourths X. And even though that will give us a negative on that side, what that does is that will only take one move to move all of the variables to this side, and it will leave the constants on that side. It's only one move instead of two. So right here, if you notice, I need a common denominator for the 2 and the 4, that's going to be 4. So 1 half is the same as 2 fourths and then x. And so if I had 2 fourths and then negative 3 fourths added together, they're opposite signs. We subtract and take the sign of the larger number. The larger is going to be the 3 fourths, so it will be negative. And then 3 fourths minus 2 fourths will be 1 fourth x. These cancel on this side to 0. 0 plus 3 is 3. And then you could do this a couple ways. You could divide both sides by negative 1 fourth if you like. The trick that I like to use here is to multiply both sides by the reciprocal, meaning we just flip exactly what I have next to x and multiply both sides, and it will cancel out. If I multiply this by negative 4 over 1 and a negative 4 over 1, because whatever I do to one side, I must do to the other. Then what's that going to do? Negative times negative is positive. 1 fourth times 4 over 1 does give me 4 over 4, which is 1, and 1 times x is x, and now the variable is isolated. That's exactly what I wanted. And then negative 4 over 1 is the same as negative 4, and negative 4 times 3 on our triangle man here. If we want to do negative times a positive, that's going to be a negative. So my answer is going to be a negative 12 for the answer to this equation with rationals, with fractions. Moving on to number 12. A small kite starts at 7.3 meters off the ground and goes up to 2.5 meters per second. A large kite starts at 12.4 meters off of the ground and goes up at 1.5 meters per second. When are the kites at the same height? And that means that x is going to be the number of seconds. All right. And then also, if we notice right here, they've already written half of our problem for us. The 7.3, that's going to be the small kite. I'll go ahead and write that right here. 7.3 plus the 2.5 meters per second. That means I'm multiplying 2.5 times x. That's 2.5x for multiplication. And then we're going to equal that to the large side, the large kite. And we'll translate that into an expression as well. And they start at 12.4 meters off of the ground. That'll be 12.4 plus it's going up at 1.5 meters per second. The seconds being x, I'll multiply 1.5 times x. All right. Then we will solve. I will choose to move the variables to this side and the constants to this side. And I'm going to go ahead and subtract the 1.5x on both sides. What's that going to give me? That's going to be 7.3 brought down plus 2.5 minus 1.5 is going to be only 1x, or just x, equal to. And then I can bring down the 12.4, and then notice my 1.5x's cancel. From there, I could simply subtract 7.3 from both sides. And when we do that, our answer is going to be x equal to 5.1. And in this case, that's going to be 5.1 seconds before the two kites. That answers our question. When are the heights at the same, or sorry, the kites at the same height? It's after 5.1 seconds, or at 5.1 seconds, exactly. Number 13, and the inequality here, we're going to go ahead and solve that by picking a side for our variables. Notice if I move the negative 35 over to this side, that is going to give us a positive coefficient. So I will do that to get rid of that negative 35x. I'll add 35x to both sides. So plus 35x. And then that is going to cancel right here. And I get 500 negative 15x plus 35x negative 15 plus 35 will give me a positive 20 because I subtract to take the sign of the larger. That's 35 is definitely larger, so that stays positive, and 35 minus 15 is 20. Bringing down the inequality sign, bringing down the 800. Now I will subtract the 500, and that will give me 800 minus 500 is going to be 300, and then 20x will also come down. Do I flip the inequality? No, I don't, because we're not dividing by a negative. We're only going to divide by the 20 that's in front of x, and that's going to give us x greater than, because the inequality sign did not flip, and then that's going to be 15. You could cancel zeros there, and 30 divided by 2 is 15, or simply divide 300 by 20. You get the same answer, x greater than 15. Moving on to number 14, we're going to pick variables and aside for variables and aside for constants. Since I already have a negative over here, if I move the negative 4x to this side, it does turn positive. So an easy fix there, we will add 4x to both sides, and that will give us 7x. 3x plus 4x is 7x greater than the 7 and the negative 4x and positive 4x cancel. Then you will divide both sides by 7. Not flipping the sign there because I only divided by a positive. That means x is greater than 7 divided by 7, which is 1. Moving on to number 15. Write an inequality to represent this relationship. 5, and we're going to translate. Of course, x is going to be the number that we don't know, the missing number. So 5 plus, that's pretty straightforward, 3/4 of a number. If you hear a fraction coupled with the word of, that's going to mean multiplication. I guess that x could be an x, but let me go ahead and just write multiply just so there's no confusion there. So we're going to multiply 3/4 times that number. That's definitely going to be x because I don't know the number. So 3/4 times x, or just 3/4 x. And then on the other side, it says is less than. That means this whole expression is going to get pointed to because that side has to be less than. And then we're going to do 2 times the number. We don't know the number. That's that same number that we were talking about, though. It's x. So 2 times that number, that will be 2x. We could solve that particular problem, that inequality. However, they just asked us to write the inequality. So we're done. Number 16, we have an inequality with rationals, with fractions. And so we're going to solve that. And we're going to draw a line straight down. And to start, let's go ahead and move this negative 3/4 x to this side. I'll choose to put variables on this side, constants on this side. And that, because the negative 3/4 is smaller, I could add, well, just the fact that it will turn all of my variables positive, I'll just add 3/4 x to both sides. So when you add 3/4 x to 3x, that's like adding 75 cents to $3. And so all of a sudden we have 375, or 3 3/4 x. I'll bring down the minus 1/2. The inequality comes down. My 3/4 x's will cancel, and I'll bring down the 12. From there, I will add 1/2 to both sides. And then $12 plus 50 cents is $12.50. Or we could just look at it as 12 plus 1/2 is 12.5. So this will be 3 3/4 x. Let me make sure that 3 is larger because it's a whole number. 3 3/4 x. We bring down the inequality, and as we stated, 12 plus 1/2 is 12.5. Let me go ahead and rewrite this horizontally so that we can actually divide. You could divide both sides by 3 3/4 right here. You could see that 3 right there. That's a 3/4. 3 3/4 is getting divided on both sides. So let me write this horizontally. That's going to be the 12 that's actually getting divided. I'll write it right here. So it's going to be 12 1/2. that's getting divided by the 3 3/4. From there, we're going to change these to improper fractions. You could multiply, then add. And same thing here, multiply, then add. 12 times 2 is 24 plus 1 is going to be 25. So this will be 25 over 2 divided by 3 times 4 is 12 plus 3 is 15 over 4. And then if you remember, for division of fractions, you're going to change this to multiplication and then flip this second fraction. So keep the 25 over 2 as it looks, but change the division of multiplication and flip this second fraction to 4 over 15. We're going to cross cancel or cross simplify. 2 will go into 2 one time, 2 goes into 4 two times, and then we will multiply straight across. 25 times 2, that's going to be 15. And then 1 times 15 will be 15. So then we're going to simplify. We know that 5, these are both divisible by 5. So I'll divide both the top and bottom by 5. And then 50 divided by 5, that's going to be 10. And then 15 divided by 5 is 3. So it doesn't go in evenly. 3 does not go into 10 evenly, but we can get a mixed number. So I'm going to go ahead and bring down these cancel. I have x, I have my inequality sign, and then 3 goes into 10 3 times. 3 times 3 is 9, and if you remember, your remainder will go on top of your fraction. 3 times 3 is 9, 10 minus 9 is going to be a remainder of 1, and that's going to be 3 on the bottom for your denominator to maintain that 3 right there. So your answer is going to be x less than 3 1/3. As a reminder, make sure that you flip your inequality sign if you do divide or multiply by negative. Hope this helps. Have a great day.